Before buying a Tesla, you probably have this perception that they're really expensive, that you're going to spend a ton of money, and it's probably just out of your price range. Well, that may have been true a few years back, but now with the Model 3 and the entire used market for Model S and Model X, things are becoming much more affordable. But you still have to figure out what that monthly cost is going to be. And there are a few different categories and ways to go about it. And so that's what this video is meant to do, is to help walk you through all the different considerations to figure out how much a Tesla is going to cost you each month. Let's go. Like I said, there are a few different categories of costs that we need to figure out. First, we need to figure out the price of the vehicle, and if we finance it, what will that cost be? As well as if we leased it, what would that cost be? Then we need to figure out charging. How are we going to charge it? How are we going to actually fuel the vehicle? And how much will that cost? And then lastly, what is our insurance cost? I'm intentionally leaving off a few categories here that you may consider in the true cost of owning a vehicle, because what I want to focus on solely here is how much money you will actually spend each month. So in looking for a Tesla, there are a couple different places to go. If you're going new, obviously you'll go to Tesla.com and just spec out whatever model you want. From there, it'll give you the cash price, the lease price, if it's available for lease, and a loan price, if you can get a loan through Tesla. Now, you could also get a loan from another bank. Often, the local credit union, wherever you live, will give you a better interest rate. So go explore that, and on their websites or calling them will give you what your loan amount would be. But here's one that I would price out if I were doing it today. So I would probably buy for myself a long-range Model S if I were in the market for a brand new Tesla. And pricing this out with just the white multi-coat that comes with it, the 19-inch wheels, the black interior, no upgrade for the full self-driving, just the built-in autopilot, it looks like my purchase price would be just under $80,000. If I were to lease this on a 36-month lease with $7,500 down and a limit of 10,000 miles, which honestly is pretty low, I'm looking at around $899 a month. So a pretty hefty price tag for my car here. And if I wanted to get a loan for this from Tesla with a 3.99% annual percentage rate on 72 months with $3,000 down, I'm looking at $1,223. So all in on the new side of it, to me, that is a pretty expensive vehicle. Honestly, there are so many good used Model S's available, I probably wouldn't do that. So if I were to find a Model S, if I really were going to down this road, I would certainly be looking at the used market as well. And you can do that at tesla.com/used. I would recommend focusing on battery mostly, like how much range you get out of the vehicle and whether or not it has autopilot. I think those are two really important features to focus on if you're buying a used Tesla. As well, you could do a Model 3 here. So what I want you to do for this step, just follow along, is find the car you're interested in buying. Figure out, just as I did through the Tesla website, what is that monthly price going to be? Or if you're going to get a loan from a credit union or some other bank, go to their website and all of them should have a calculator for your auto loan payment. Go figure that out and write that number down. For me, I'm going to use this 2016 Tesla Model S 85D that I found for $46,900, which gives me a monthly payment of $675. The next category is charging. So depending on where you live, there are going to be a lot of different things that go into this. So I'm going to use myself as an example and mention other things that you may want to consider. So when it comes to charging, you likely are going to have some mix of supercharging, maybe some level 2 charging, like a destination charger. Maybe your work has a charger that you can use, and charging at home. So all told, you're not going to be doing it 100% at home. So this number we're going to calculate here is going to be a little different than what you end up paying. Hopefully less. Now, I didn't find a really good calculator online for this. I think Tesla used to have one. So I ended up building my own, and I'll put a link to it down in the description for you. And here's how to use it. First, you start off with which model you're choosing. And this is important because it gives us our watt hours per mile, which is similar to the miles per gallon in a gas car. Then you punch in whatever your current gas car is, or what you would consider a comparable one for this analysis. I have 32 miles per gallon here as a default. Change it to whatever makes sense. Then you need to figure out your electricity price in the kilowatt hour measurement. So you can get this from your electricity bill. If you log into whatever that is, for me, it's SDG&E, go to your bill details, and usually in there, it'll tell you the different rate. Now, a lot of companies, this isn't that well known, a lot of companies offer time of use rating, where they will actually give you a discounted rate at certain times a day when you can charge your car, and use that instead of the overall rate, the average rate. So in California, where I live, we have this EV time of use rating system from SDG&E. I go to their website, I see that in this category of what they call super off-peak charging, just starting at midnight, the rate per kilowatt hour drops to 9 cents. So that's a great deal. Now, I'll talk about solar in a second, but what you need to do now is go find that rate, whatever it is for you. And if you have the option to get a special rate, go look at that, search it out with your power company, and put that number into the calculator. Next, we'll do price of gas, and maybe you know what that is, and you can just punch a number in off the top of your head, but you can also use different websites to find this. So we have a AAA website that has this, as well as Gas Buddy, which is meant to help you find the cheapest gas. They show all these kind of rates, and they can kind of localize it down to your area. So punch in the average price of gas in your area. The next input we need to figure out charging is how many miles you drive. I've defaulted this to 1,300 miles, which is on par with the average in the United States. Of course, every person's situation is different, so make sure that this mirrors whatever it is going to be for you, because this obviously is a key factor in figuring out how much money you're going to spend. Then once you have all those details plugged in, you will see the results down below. So for my example here, where the price of electricity is 9 cents per kilowatt hour, the average price of gas is $3.78, the gas car I'm comparing to would get 32 miles per gallon, say a Honda Civic or something, and I am looking at a Model S, my total for the month is around $44.50. The gas would cost me $153.60, giving me a savings of 71.1%. Pretty good deal. Now, if you are getting a Model 3, just select that model. And if you're getting a Model X, select that one. But make sure also to update the miles per gallon to the comparative vehicle. So if you get a Model X, you're looking at a bigger car, not, you know, a small coupe like a Honda Accord or something. So make sure that just those are commensurate, so that way the comparison is valid. Also on the bottom, you'll notice that the watt hours per mile, I didn't have you input, because a lot of these calculators I've seen online just use these kind of numbers that were generated in a lab, something that isn't actually reflective of reality. Well, here through TesLab, I'm able to pull the anonymous driving data of thousands upon thousands of Tesla owners. So when you see that you click the Model 3 versus Model S versus Model X, it tells you how many driving trips are included and then what the median watt hours per mile is. Now, the median is good versus the average, because you could have things skewed heavily one way or the other. So the median is kind of a nice way just to kind of filter out all that extra noise and find out, you know, generally what's closer to reality for you. So this is where we pull that number from. It's not something that was just thrown out there from an engineering team. This is real world data that's being used to power these numbers. So let me talk real quickly about solar. Now, if you have solar already, you probably know this stuff, but if you are buying an EV, quickly you'll realize that getting solar on your home actually makes a lot of sense, because you're using a ton more electricity. As well, after 2019, the federal tax credit for solar starts to reduce. It starts to phase out. So if you're on the fence about it now, you don't have a whole lot of time to really figure this out. And the way I would recommend doing that is going to Energy Sage and plugging in your info and having solar installers bid on your project, giving you all the details before you actually talk to any salesperson. I personally used Energy Sage, and then I became a partner of theirs because I love what they do. They present to you all the bids and everything in kind of a really nice laid out dashboard that shows you the facts before you get all the marketing pitch and start being talked into things you probably don't need. So definitely check out Energy Sage. I'll put a link to them down below, and use this to figure out how much money you could actually save by going solar. And with that information, you can then back into how much per kilowatt hour you would spend and update this calculator to figure out a more true charging cost. So for example, I was able to determine that my per kilowatt hour cost is around 7 cents versus the 9 cents that the utility is charging me. Now, I got this by taking the total cost of my system, which was $14,779, dividing that by the warranty of 25 years, giving me an annual cost of $591.16. Then I saw that my solar system was generating 8,510 kilowatt hours each year, or last year it did anyways. And then dividing those two numbers gave me just above 6.9 cents per kilowatt hour. So I'm calling it 7 cents per kilowatt hour. So if I plug this number into the calculator, you see that my savings actually increased quite a bit from 71% to 77.5%. And the total electricity cost per month is $34.60, so about 10 bucks cheaper than before. The next thing to look at is insurance. And Tesla just recently started offering their own insurance. Now, I don't think you're actually able to get a quote unless you have an account, but I went and did that. And for my Model S, it was around $120 a month. For my Model 3, it was $133. So both of those are quite a bit more than I currently pay with Farmers. With Farmers, I have three cars, I have my house, and I have life insurance. And I've been with them for a while. I have direct deposit or automatic debit. So I get a lot of discounts and things. So I would call your insurance provider, go to their website, or go to the Tesla website, see if you can do it. For me, it makes me log in, but maybe they'll change that by the time you're watching this. Also, you can get one at eSurance. So I'll put a link to that down below and kind of figure out exactly what your insurance cost would be. For me, since I already have this set up here, I'm gonna list it as $120, the quote that Tesla gave me, as if I were buying this brand new. So all that's left to do now is add all these up to figure out that monthly cost. If you recall, we have the $675 payment for the car. We have $34.60 for charging, which includes the cost of solar. We have $120 in insurance, and this gives us a grand monthly total of $829.60. So $830 a month is a fair amount, and you know, it's not definitely on the cheaper end. But if you were to compare this to some of the other vehicles out there in this category, remember we're getting the Model S here, I think you'd find that with the reduced cost of maintenance and repairs, this actually isn't that bad because you're saving 77% on fuel. Insurance is going to be very subjective, and the payment really is going to be the same because it's just a loan. So it just varies on the price of the car. So if you bought another gas car for this same dollar amount, I can guarantee you'd be saving quite a bit of money here. Now, this number for you is going to be different. And the point of this video and the point of that calculator I built was to just help you figure that out, help you figure out exactly how much you're going to spend. The thing I would never recommend anyone doing is getting in over their head when it comes to a vehicle. Vehicles depreciate. They're not like things like you live in. They're not your house. They don't go up in value. They're not an investment. So if this number that I showed you here is way too much, way more expensive than you're willing to pay, that's fine. Find one that is. For example, on the very low end, you can lease a Model 3 for $399 a month. And then if you add in $133 for the insurance that I just mentioned from the quote from Tesla and $26.50 for charging, which is what it would come out for the Model 3 using the same 7 cents per kilowatt hour that I figured out before, you're looking at $558.50. Still, it's not a cheap car, but if you were to take a similarly priced gas car, say a BMW 3 Series, and run all these numbers, you're going to find that you are spending quite a bit more on fuel and maintenance and everything else. So this is just a tool for you to help figure out exactly how much you are going to spend when you buy your first Tesla. And hopefully this will just kind of remain as a reference point for you so that way you can explain these things and make sure that you're not just kind of overextending yourself. So let me know in the comments if there's any pieces I missed here. I'll try to update that calculator as best I can and kind of keep it, you know, fresh for you guys so it's useful over time. And of course, share this video with anyone you know that is curious about how much it may cost to, say, charge their Tesla each month. And that's it for now. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and don't forget, when you free the data, your mind will follow. I'll see you guys back here in the next one. Hey, thanks for watching the video. I hope you got something out of it. And I hope that tool helps you figure out the true cost that you're gonna spend on charging your Tesla, as well as all the other stuff that I mentioned on how to figure that out. Now, if you wanna join the community, chat with folks like me daily, ask more questions of people and get better insights, consider joining us at patreon.com/teslanomics, and I hope to see you there soon.